Hello and welcome to Driving with Todd, and I'm Todd. I received a comment from a YouTuber that goes by the name Gary A. And Gary A. writes, "Lines on my face from the Frampton Comes Alive, please. No one had done it yet, and I think it's his best tune." So we're going to do that. We're gonna see what Lines on My Face sounds like on Frampton Comes Alive. Now, a little bit of history before we go there, because that's kind of what my show's about, is Frampton had done four albums previous to the Frampton Comes Alive album. The first three that he did, starting in 1971 through 74, never broke Billboard's top 100 in the United States. It wasn't until his Frampton album, which came out in 1975, that he actually got to number 32 on Billboard's top 100. When Frampton Comes Alive came out, it just, for some odd reason, struck people as a phenomenal album. It's one of the best live albums ever recorded, and sales-wise as well. Over 8 million copies of this album have been sold. So I got on the bandwagon because I did not buy the first four albums by Peter Frampton. I was a little miffed at Peter Frampton for leaving Humble Pie. I loved Humble Pie, and Peter Frampton was really important to that group. He fit into that group perfectly. And when he left a hole in that group. As far as I'm concerned, he left a hole. And his songwriting with Humble Pie was phenomenal. He did some really great songs with that group. So when he left, it was like I saw all the Frampton albums come out, but I kind of just let him sit there. It was like, no, I'm not going there. Well, when Frampton Comes Alive came out and everybody was gobbling this album up, well, I joined in. I bought the album too and played it and just loved the album. So I loved it so much, I went back and bought those first four albums by Peter Frampton and found out they're really pretty good albums. I mean, they were good stuff. Now, I don't really remember this particular song. I haven't heard the album Frampton Comes Alive in probably 35 years. It's got to be about 35 years. I bought a lot of music and I always move forward. So I would buy an album, I'd listen to it, and I might listen to it for about a year even, and then it would go on my shelf, and I was moving forward buying other records, and I very rarely went back and pulled and listened to these older albums. So I have not heard this in about 35 years. I'm sure if I hear the song, I may recognize it. So I'm just saying that it's going to be one of those things where, yeah, I remember the song, or nope, I don't remember the song. So we're going to do that. The second thing is that this album, started in April of 1976, the album came out January 1976, starting in April 1976 through October of 1976, it reached number one for 10 weeks, but they weren't consecutive weeks. It'd get to number one, then bounce up, something would replace it, and then it'd go back to number one, and it did that from April to October. So that's amazing that an album, a live album, hit the charts and was at number one for 10 weeks in the United States. That is phenomenal. The other thing is I actually got to see Peter Frampton live at Summerfest in 2004. He was touring and he ended up at Summerfest, and I think it was a later act too on one of the stages, and was able to see him, and he was very good. I mean, his guitar work was phenomenal. So with that said, we're going to listen to and watch this video of Lines on My Face by Peter Frampton from the Frampton Comes Alive album. So here we go. Thank you.
from that one thing she said. She spoke of strangers that don't sleep too bad. Kept on trying, buying time, not waiting on fate. I somehow got the feeling that I opened my eyes too late. So where you came from, called out your name, but there's no answer. We live on your doorstep.
Okay, stop it right there. We're about 2 minutes into the song. What I really like about Peter Frampton is his guitar playing, his style. It's not like this hard rock, you know, burn the fretboard lead guitar. It's more of a real nice, soothing type guitar playing. He really takes his time to get the best notes out of his guitar. I really like the way he does that. The other thing is I really like his voice, and that's kind of, when I said I was upset with him when he left Humble Pie, that was one of the reasons. His voice was so different than Steve Marriott's in Humble Pie. And when he did a song, it was just so great because his voice was just so different. You could tell right away, okay, this is Peter Frampton. I mean, he's just got this really kind of smooth voice. His voice is almost as smooth as his guitar playing. And that's what I see here. Now, I don't remember the song. Again, I haven't heard the album in 35 years, so probably if I pull the album and start listening to it over and over, this will become familiar with me. But I just really don't remember the song. But this is really good. I just really like his guitar playing and the way he sings. He's got such a smooth voice.
We live on your doorstep. Made you my wife. I don't need that.
Sweet guitar solo. Like I said, he's got this way of playing his guitar. I mean, it's very smooth, it's very controlled. And even there where he was just, you know, he was kind of jamming a little bit harder on his guitar, It's like he's got total control. He's not like going to all of a sudden just take off like a rocket. He's going to keep this thing smooth and just really well placed. The other thing I want to say about this album is the way it was recorded. I mean, it was one of the first live albums that was recorded like you were there. I mean, it's so well mixed. Recorded and mixed. I mean, the drumming is right there. You hear the bass guitar. You hear, you know, almost him on his fretboard, stroking his fretboard. The recording is just a phenomenal recording. And I think that's what sold this album. It's like you put it on in your living room, and it's like Peter Frampton and his band's right in your living room. It is recorded so well. So let's continue this. This is really good. I want to go back and do that guitar solo again. I hope you don't mind, but just think that was really a good guitar solo. I think right about here.
Now there's so many people, my family and friends, trying so hard to make me smile. Till this heartache man, I saw where you came from, called out your name, but there's no answer. We live on your doorstep. Made you my wife. I don't need that. We'll be right back.
and the audience loves it. They are just applauding like crazy. That was great. That was great. I, like I said, I don't remember the song. Doesn't mean that I haven't heard it a whole lot of times when I listened to the album back in the mid-70s. But, wow, I mean, that is great. The guitar solos in there. He does two extended guitar solos, and they're both really excellent. And like I said, he's got a unique voice, but it's really a cool voice. I just really like his voice. He's got kind of a smooth singing style, similar to the way he plays guitar. Like I said, the two are very similar. And yeah, I mean, this is really great. And the album, like I said, is just a phenomenal album. I mean, it's probably, they say it's one of the, I think it's the, like the top fourth best live album ever recorded up to today. And yeah, I mean, it was just, I remember when it came out, it was just nuts. People just bought this thing like there was no tomorrow. But great song, Lines on My Face by Peter Frampton. Just really, really well done. And like I said, I saw Peter Frampton at Summerfest in Milwaukee in 2004. And yeah, he controlled the stage, and the backup band was there just to fill in the gaps that his guitar didn't take up. So this is really good. I loved it. And like I said, I really like Peter Frampton. I bought his following albums as well. You know, I'm in U Elm. I just really love that album. That was just such a good album as well. The one that came out right after Frampton Comes Alive and so on. So this was great. Thank you for the recommendation. It was a great recommendation. I hope everybody that watched loved Peter Frampton do Lines on My Face and appreciated it as much as I did. And if you did, hit that like button. If you have any comments about Peter Frampton, Lines on My Face, Frampton Comes Alive album, or, you know, what were you doing when you bought that album? You know, give us a little bit of history here. Put it in the comments. That'd be really cool. And if you haven't done so, please subscribe to my channel. Just do it, and I'd really appreciate it. And if you ring the bell, you'll get updates to my latest videos. So that was Peter Frampton. Awesome. It was just awesome. I hope it put a smile on your face. It put a big smile on my face. And peace out, baby.